woman, Matt, and I leaned against the window and look what happened. Fucking bastard. Anyway, I gotta paint that again.
Problem solved.
Okay, let's break this down. So, I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory, isn't it? Those are the measurements, 1860, and then this is 90 mil, so you'll find that this is incorrect. What did I? That's not right. Oh, that's to the window height. So that goes from the bottom all the way up to the bottom of that window, which I want to frame out. So that's 1360. On the other side, it'll be the 1860 minus the 90 mil here, which will bring us to 1770. In here, we've got 490 on the bottom before it gets to the wheel arch, and then 545 to the wall, totaling 1035 of the full width, as you can see up there. And this 1270 is basically this minus 90. Okay, so it's basically from the bottom of the wheel arch to where we want to frame up the window. This not as important. That line should end there, so that's a bit misleading. So this is incorrect and it should just end there, right? So that is from 1270 is from the bottom, the top of the wheel arch to the bottom of the window frame. Okay, so this is a really lightweight as opposed to the bracket, this big bracket that I've been using. This is heavy duty. For its purpose, it's good, but it's quite heavy. So what I'm thinking is I'm going to get some of this aluminium, same thickness, but much lighter. It's thinner, but it still houses the wood fine, you know. So if I've got the rivets here, they'll go into the bus, and then from the underside, I can just drill some holes and go straight into the wood, and that will hold it perfectly. That is fucking hot. Woo!
Hot!
Wow, that's gonna leave a mark. That's gonna leave a fucking mark. That was hot. I mean, duh. I'm gonna let that cool down a bit while I apply some cream or I don't know. Yeah, that's gonna fucking hurt. Okay, it's raining, so I've got to get all this stuff inside. But I've had I'm tired just because I went to Bunnings and it took fucking way too long. I've got to put this inside, and I got this, which I'll put in the back undercover. It's a pain in the ass, but I'll just chuck all of them. Maybe in here with these guys, but I gotta work quickly because I don't want the stuff to get wet. I just came outside and noticed it was raining, but I came back from Bunnings and I was just like, I don't know, all my energy just got drained, you know, like because I needed to rent the trailer to bring this piece of wood back, and it took me 15 minutes max to bring it here and drop it off and go back in total, and it took them like half an hour to 45 minutes in total to process it. So I feel drained. I'm drained. All right, anyway, in Bunnings I also got some of these. I got some really good advice at Bunnings, so from one of the guys there, and coincidentally he used to own a motorhome for 10 years. He lived in it for 10 years and traveled Australia. He was giving me mad advice about things to do. He was telling me that he hit a curb once and his fridge was in, and then his fridge went halfway down the bus. So I'm like, okay, things need to really be secured here. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to get the weird dog over here to give me a hand. There's the weird dog. I'm going to get the weird dog to give me a hand and bring this stuff in. I didn't even get a chance to busk today, and I kind of need to. But that's all right. I'm just tired now. I'm just going to chill out, maybe take a nap or something. These 40 mil pieces, square blocks, I made on the table saw from the 'Tied it up. The only thing I need to do is take that to the back. I was thinking about getting the 3 millimeter thick ones, but I was looking at these and thinking it doesn't need to do much. It just needs to hold up the wood. It's not a load bearing wall, so it's going to be fine. I'm going to attach 3 brackets across and 1 down that way, and that's where I'm going to run my square pieces of wood that I created on my table saw. And So as we've already discussed, so the bracket will go there or up top. I haven't decided yet, and it will hold that. And then on that will go the panel, the plywood panel. I'm going to be eating noodles for probably a week. But you know what? It's so hot because like I'm going to be closer to having this where it needs to be. So. This is actually pretty exciting for me, this whole thing that's happening right here. Can you tell I'm excited? I'm so excited about this shit. Yeah. Alright, I'll see you guys later. I'm back! I forgot to tell you, while I was at Bunnings, this is the reason I'll be eating noodles. Bam! Right? Which way does that go? This way. This is a complete barn door track set. I had some concerns because obviously we're in a moving vehicle. The immediate concern is when I attach this rail here, no problem there. When I attach that and I put the wheels on, shit, I gotta allow room for the wheels. We're talking about it hanging. I might need to maybe even cut into this. What are we looking at here? It's quite a pronounced wheel. Anyway, if we can actually get that, it's gonna be tough. Anyway, I've committed to it. I've bought it. The wheels, while I'm moving, they might jump up off the rail and the door falls off. Right, that's what was my concern. So I spoke to the guy at Bunnings. He said, and we came up with an idea that we could actually get the thing to. Once it slides into place, right, we can attach some sort of mechanism here that will sort of lock it into the wall, you know, so it becomes part of the wall and not just a freestanding door on two wheels. So these are ready meals. They've got a shelf life of 18 months. And basically it's a prepping food, you know, for those preppers. But this was given to me by my brother to try. So I'm going to try it. And all that I need to do, apparently, is to chuck it in here, just like this. So immerse the unopened foil pouch in boiling water for about 5 minutes. move, cut open, and serve hot. Or you could do it in the microwave, but nah. So they are called palak paneer. Pure and perfect MTR. I don't know what the actual, I don't know if that's the name of the food. And that's, I think that's the company, that's, I think that's the food name. So this is a spinach, spiced spinach gravy with cottage cheese. So, bam, it's mild. 100% natural ingredients. And I'm not sure where you get these, but I'm sure if you can look that up, you can find it. It says it serves two, but I reckon I'll smash this. Oh, I have to make rice. Oh, okay. So I better make some rice as well. I mean, it doesn't, it's green. It smells good. Yeah, it's not bad. Not bad. Like, the gap is there, and as I said, like, once I put the wall in, you won't notice it, but you can kind of tell, you can kind of tell that there's a little bit of live seepage. I'm considering going full way with that, and then halfway here, up to here, up to where that line is, and that will mean we go from half there and that whole window on this side. From this side, I'll probably finish this window and black it all out on this side, and same up top. If I need light, I can open the window, and obviously there's the light inside. As for this, if I have a general thing where along the bus where I make it black just about there, because the bed is right at this height right there, so there's going to be obviously pillows and stuff, but also I'm going to think about putting a headboard. Look, I blend in. You couldn't see me if I went like this. I don't know. You can't see me? You can't see me? Ha! Again, some light leaks. You know, like, it wouldn't be such a bad thing if it leaked. You can, paint, because if I'm painting this, you know, this is already black, so From in this light, you can't really see it. I can see it pretty well, but I mean, it's just reflecting. As opposed to you can see through it, you cannot see a damn thing. Great. Just great. Alright, there's the cover, there's the leaks covered. She ain't pretty, but she'll do the job. Once that's dried up, who cares? And I did this side too. I think there's a couple of bits there I need to get. I haven't done much today as I predicted yesterday. So, that's okay. I was trying to, the reason was I was editing a video for you guys. Well, it's not for you guys, it's for me, but, you know, I don't know. Is it for you guys? Whatever. So basically I was editing a video this morning, and when I finished it was about 11 o'clock, and I like to start early because about, you know, 2:30, 3 o'clock is a good time for me to leave and look for a place to busk. So I haven't got much time to work. It's a little early for me to go busk, but what I thought I'd do today is I'm actually feeling a little musical, so I might go and do two busking sessions. There's a spot that I've wanted to play at for a while, but every time I go there, someone's already there busking. It's a good spot, and I want to try and get there early today. For the buskers out there, time-wise, you know, 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock to 7 o'clock, usually are good times because of there's higher traffic. It's a terrible time to try and travel to a place because there is a lot of traffic. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the spot that I've wanted to go to for a while early. So it probably won't be as good as it could be, but you know, I want to get there and play there, and then I might do a second location after that. So I didn't get the spot, but I thought if I come here early I might get it, but I didn't. But this guy's pretty good. I think I've seen him here before. I'm going to have to chat to him anyway, see what he's up to and stuff. And I'm probably just going to look for another spot and go from there. Maybe come back later. Sink into the ground, I don't know what will. Now we've just got a full window. No emergency exit sign, just a window. lovely. All right, welcome to my roof. This is my roof. And a little bit dirty. A little bit dirty. This will all come off real easy. Give it a nice shine, but this is my roof. This is where I will have my deck and my solar set up. I eventually want to get up here, but this ladder is probably not the best ladder for this. And I want to find a secure way to get up and down, so. Well, we're going to get quite acquainted with this place eventually. While I'm here, I'll just check these channels. I think these channels here are what guide the water sort of away from the bus. And I don't see any way for water to travel into the bus from here. Not from this angle anyway. Just from looking at this, it's really flexible, if you can see that, flexing. So I'm not 100% sure about the walking on top of it. Obviously, there's when we put the deck, we'll be anchoring onto these points here to supply like a little thing that will bring it up to the height of the top of here. And then across there, we can run the deck. Obviously, solar panels will have to find a way on here as well. There's plenty of room, but the more solar I can get, the better. And that will obviously affect the size of the deck. So there might be a way that I have to make them sort of coexist. Maybe I could put solar panels on the deck that can be removed when the deck is in use. So maybe they could fold up. To space it out is I'm going to place just a bracket there, and then above that is where I'm going to drill these holes. So I basically want that to sit there like so, leaving this window section clear just in case. I just wanted to make sure that that was completely flat, and because it was kind of bowing a bit, so now it is, it's there roughly. Oh, I'm going backwards. Fuck. No wonder. Stupid. Alright, here we go. Thank you. Come. Come and check this out. So I haven't put all the rivets in, but it's pretty sturdy at the moment. I'm just going to put this there. And that's basically, if I allow enough room from the sides, this doesn't really matter because there's going to be a wall on top. So, but I just want to be able to slide in the board here, and that should leave me enough room. So if I just favour this side a bit and I screw it in that way, I'll be fine. So essentially that's the first one, right? And then we get another one of these. That one's gonna run there and give us another piece of wood to work off. Sit there somewhere like so, anywhere, it doesn't matter. And then there's gonna be another one here. What do you reckon? And then, I mean, I could just go, I'll put another one there just for the, make it solid. And then I'll put one right down the bottom. Over here. This one I might put this way to make it easier to screw in the wood, because there's no way I'm going to be able to screw it in from underneath. So if I put it this way, I guarantee that I can at least get to the top and screw the wood in from the downways upwards, and then once that's in, it should lock in with the wall. So 1, 2, and 3 plus that one, and we're going to have a nice sturdy wall area that we can rig up. If I wanted to get really fucking, if I put it up here, I think what'll start happening is it'll start to bow. So we'll just leave it at that for now. But look how nice that wood sits there, and there's not even one screw in it. That's a shelf, baby. Cool, huh? I'm stoked. Rap star, walking all built down, 늘어나는 팀 네가 싫어하던 게 늘어나. Living more life, better life, 독 따라오는 사랑은 나 thanks to the God. 한기만은 밥도 넘어지면 다시 일어나서 세상에 충지를 빡. 왔던 대로 그냥 하던 대로 style 쌓인 좋은 가고 그냥 막 가는 거지. 이제 말만 하는 워너비들 깔아놓고 수면으로 하여 위로 올라가지. Rap for team, 네가 바라던 팀 아메리 내 보고 할리우드 건전히 아무도 못 보는 이유 난 너무 높아 억지로지 않는 그 위치. 니들 타고 다닐 거라 switch, fuck your team now we.
Another level of lies, 더 큰 거짓말 위해 삶. I got another level of lies, 나는 더 큰 세상을 삶. 또 다른 목표는 나는 그쳐 비현실과 현실은 나름대로 섞어. 머릿속에 내 모습은 겹쳐 나가 떨어지는 나 혼자 는 바로 나요. Well, 향기가 나는 rap game 아로마 아로마에 빠져 정신이 높은 나요. 일요일인 일에 발을 딱 가르마 종교에 빠져 시신이 높은가요. 아니면 나는 그냥 살고 싶은가요. 또 아니면 나는 그냥 알고 싶은가요. 나도 돼요 빈 same motherfucker 나는 그냥 하고 싶은 대로 살아가는가요. Fuck it.
All right. So I've definitely got a leak here in this channel, as you can see. I'm 100% sure now that the water is traveling down here, because I just drilled a hole through that. So, how does water get in there? Well, I would say, well, we've already talked about this. It's got to be come from up there. All right, so I've started the bus, and as you can see, water is coming through here. I'm just going to get a rag. Stop that. We know there's a leak there. For now, I'm going to continue with my work. I just have to fix it, and so that it's not an ongoing thing and it creates a problem. This side is a little bit different. It'll just have the 1, 2, and 3, possibly. Not too sure about the bottom one yet, so we'll see what we do. So, my option here is I can frame this. I'll have to frame this out, sort of, kind of, you know, somehow. That would be the best thing for me to do, is to find a way to attach a piece of wood up there and in there. So tomorrow I will do the other side, which is behind me here. And I'll have to maybe start filling these walls here with the ply that I got, ply board, just so I can see where things are going to sit. So far it's looking pretty good, and I'm pretty happy.
Rah, rah, rah.